Hi, welcome to Fixed by Doc, and today I'm going to renovate this chair that has been, it's an old chair, it's been torn up by my cats, and as you can see there, and the other side was made with these straps here, zoom out again, it was made with these straps here for whatever reason, and they have snapped and stuff, and it's missing a board here. I have that board somewhere, but I can't find it right now, so I'm not going to be replacing that part today. That's just simple. Put it back in, pop in a screw and some glue, and that part's fixed. But what I'm main thing I'm going to do today is recover this. I'm going to add some padding to the back and recover it, and I'm going to completely redo the whole seat portion there. And I'm going to cut all this old stuff off and remove it, and then I'll show you that. Then the generator's running right now because I need to hook up the skill saw so I can cut a new board to go on there and to go on where the seat is, so I'm not going to have those straps anymore. I'm going to have a nice solid board. And I'm going to use the same cushion that's on there, but I'm also going to add this memory foam to it. This is, got this from Walmart today. It's a memory foam chair pad. So this will go on the plywood here. I'm going to cut these tie straps off and take the tags off. And it will sit on the board. And then I'll take the foam that's on there already and set that over it. And then I'm going to take the black digi pattern camo here, most likely. If there's enough of this green stuff to go for the backing, then I'll use the black one for the seat cushion, or vice versa, depending on. I'm hoping that there's enough to use this for the backing, for the back panel, for that portion of the chair, and the black part for that portion. We will see. I would like to do the whole thing with this, but there's not enough material of either one to do both. So unfortunately, I can't do the whole thing. Well, we'll see, there might be enough. I'm gonna do the seat portion first. And if there's enough of this black to do the whole thing in black, then I'll do that. But I gotta see how much is here first. I'm not sure if there's gonna be enough. So I've got both pieces of material out there. This is what I would like to have it in, but I'm using the scraps of what I've got. The only thing I bought for this project was this cushion, and I got it because it's a real thick, real dense memory foam, and I sat on it at the store for a few minutes, and it felt really nice and comfortable, and I really liked it. It was $12.94. Other than that, everything else I already own and had. This chair, when I bought it, I got it from Big Lots for $39 on sale a while back. So, all right, let's get started. First thing I'm gonna do is cut off the material and see what I'm working with the base there. And then once I get all that cleaned off and removed, then I'll be able to take the measurements. I know it's approximately 19 by 19, but it's got sort of a trapezoid shape. So I know this is slightly larger than 19 by 19, so I will get the proper measurements and cut it all up, and then I'll show you what I've got going on. Alrighty, so here's the board cut, there's the chair exposed. Now there's a couple of ways I can do this that I'm contemplating. I can either wrap the seat, everything, and make this completely separate, and then wrap the fabric around there on each one of those bars, and then once that's done, set this on here, and then use some L brackets, put an L bracket underneath right in here, like an L bracket here and here. You screw the panel on when there and there, one there and one there, four of them. And then that would hold the seat on place. Option number two is I screw this on now, and then I put the seat cover on, and then I wrap it all up as one. So I'm going to think about it, and I'm going to mess around with some fabric scraps and see what I like best before I do anything permanent, and then I'll come back to you. Okay, I decided to screw the board down first, then put the padding on, and then put the fabric on around the whole thing at once. My deciding factor was how I was going to fold it around the front here. Initially, I wasn't sure if I was going to be able to make the fold around. Let me put the camera on the tripod here. What's up, chickens? There we go. Alright. Initially, I wasn't sure how I was going to make the fold around the front here. But if I take it and I pull it around underneath and I staple the sides first, then when I've got it folded and I bring it around like this, then I do fold like that, then I can staple it underneath. And when I have these initial sides, it's kind of hard to do because I don't have anything stapled yet. I'm sure I'm still in frame. There you go. When I staple this first side here, we stapled underneath. Then it comes around the front like this. And I would staple right here where my two fingers are. Then the fabric would fold over like that, making a crease that goes in line with this corner piece right here, and it flips underneath and staples down underneath. So you get a nice clean corner like that. And then I do the same thing with the other side. So that's what I've decided to do. Now I just gotta get my drill real quick. I'll set you over here so you can watch the chicken mayhem while I do some stuff. Put four screws in.
put one here in the middle too. So far, so good. It's a real thick padded memory foam thing. It's really comfortable. It's the biggest one I could find to fit the seat. There's the reason why I'm going to reuse this foam here. Perfect. Now all you gotta do is just make sure it's all gonna sit right where I want it. I think that's gonna work right there. Okay, so next up, let's see if we got enough material to do the back and the back in the seat portion out of this one sheet. I think it's gonna work out, so while I figure this out and get it cut out and get it on the backing, Then I'll turn it back on and come back to you. Okay, I decided since I had this spare piece of foam laying around here that I would slip it in behind the fabric before I got it all stapled up and ready to go here. So, add some extra cushioning back here. See what that looks like. Put them together and see what it feels like. See if it's too much. Might be too much. And then take it out. I think I'm gonna keep it in. Gives better back support. This is my personal chair. Nobody else really uses it but me. Once in a blue moon, Addie sits in it, but when I'm watching movies or on the internet, this is the chair I use. So, I wanna make it comfy for me. Addie has her own chair. Alright, I'll come back to you in a minute. So the back portion is done. Right, turn it around here so you can see it better. Starting to look like new already. Put you back on the camera stand here. Now the next step is to put the cushions on the seat portion. It's getting chilly out here and getting dark. See if that's going to be enough. I'm not sure. I'm going to cut it close if it is. I'm hoping. It'll be good long ways. Is it good this way? Oh, looks like it's going to be. So, let's grab the nail gun, the staple gun, I mean. Plenty of fabric. Okay. Push it away. Up in there.
Tapping the staples in, make sure they went in all the way. Barking at dog.
This one here. Gonna go in. Let's go in that time. There we go.
I think it went in that time.
Alright. Excellent. So now we put the cooking thing.
I'm going to trim some of this off, make it a little bit neater. Here, make sure it's the right way. Tap it down. Put it up against. Or something. I only did the corners. I should do it all the way across. Now the staples. As far as I'm concerned, you can never have too many staples, as far as I'm concerned. So I'm thinking it's going to be best to staple the front down first. Gotta go grab the dip gun. Flip the camera around so I can see. Yeah, you can see me. Leave that over here. Alright.
Okay. Hold that. It's gonna be folded right around over here. Tucked on there. I don't remember how. I'm gonna see how I'm gonna do this corner here. Let's see. I think I have to do the sides first to make the corner work. This little tear here, the way this fabric is done, it's gonna make this corner a little difficult. To conceal everything. Maybe. Be so much easier if I had an extra hand here. But Addie's actually on her way home from Florida. There we go. That's gonna work. I'm gonna put a staple right there to hold it for now. Staple jammed. Alright, I'm gonna have to. There's a couple of staples that went in bad. I'll have to come back later and pull them out and replace them. But I'm gonna try to get the most of it done at the moment. Alright, let's pull out these bad staples. What's up, chicken? Oh, wait. Okay. You ought to be nice to that chicken and let her in. Okay. I'm going to set this up on the sawhorses over here. See if I can't make it a little bit easier. Okay, I'm gonna have to trim it first, then we'll put it up on the sawhorse. There we go. Alright. Do the same to the other side. Excellent. Now we can flip it over there. Grab my tools. Pull out some of these first ones because they didn't go in all the way. This one keeps missing. Try this again. There we go. All right. Now for this corner. There we go. That side's done. Now for the other side.
Alright, let's get this corner on. Getting hard to see. I'll get in my pocket. Gonna have a little bit of extra fabric in here, it looks like. Alright, I'll come back to you in a minute when I figure this corner out. Okay, I know it's late, it's dark, and you may or may not be able to see it too well, but there's the chair, and completed, and I got to do it all in one fabric, so that was good. I'll get you a close-up on the corners in a minute. Okay, so I'll bring it over here. There's the corners. And the side. Okay, y'all may or may not like it, but I like it, and that's all that matters because it's my chair. And what really matters, all in all in the end, is that it is very comfortable. And doesn't look like it's all torn up anymore and scratched up from the kittens. And it's not that pleathery stuff anymore, so. This is a thick, heavy denim material, which holds up to the animals much better. So, alrighty, much more comfortable. Now I still gotta go do the egg a day. Alright, thanks for watching.